everybody. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend, Joe Seeby. And happy Wednesday, everybody. Today is Wednesday as part of our creative writing class that we like to call ghostwriting. For those of you who have never been here before, who have never seen this class, ghostwriting is when we take a popular song, a top 40 Billboard-based charted song, and we rewrite the chorus with our own original lyrics. Now, you're probably thinking, why do we do this? There's a lot of reasons why we do it. A, it's creative. B, you know, it gives you a chance to flex your creative muscles. Number three, when we write our own songs as songwriters, we always need to write a second verse, okay? And the hardest part for me always is coming up with verse two, because I give all my best stuff away in verse one. So, you know, this is like a similar practice run for that, because you look at the form of the chorus. The chorus is the same every time. The verses are usually the same format, but the words are different. So this is a great exercise for that, for getting your chops up for writing your second verse, okay? There's so many positives to this exercise. And one of the reasons is, just think of this too. At the end of the day, you're left with your own original words. You can change the melody and then they become your, you have your own brand new original chorus. That's really good, you know? The only thing that I ask in this is, of course, it's got to rhyme and it's got to make sense. And like, if you look at this, if you look at their chorus, what I'd like you to do is write their chorus down all the way, every word of their chorus, and then leave a space after each line. So write their first line here, then the second line on your paper, write your words. You should have the same amount of words. And if their word has, if their one of the words in their line has two syllables, so should yours. If their line has three syllables, then your word should have three syllables. And if that doesn't work, as long as if you have like a three-syllable word that equals their one syllable plus two syllables, that's fine. I accept that. That's really, really cool. But, you know, one of the main reasons I started doing this in class was because it really forces you to think. It forces you to be creative because you only have a few amount of lines to say what you need to say. Like, especially in this song that we're looking at tonight, which I'll get to in a minute. You know, their lines are only 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's like the first line has 4 words. The second line has 5. That's not a lot of words, really, when you think about a chorus, right? You got to say a lot in a short amount of time. And it's got to sum it up. And everyone's got to understand what the chorus is saying. You can't explain a chorus. They either get the chorus or they don't get the chorus. It's that simple. And like I say every week, this is one of those exercises that, you know, you can't do this while you're texting your friend Ruth, or you're balancing your checkbook, or you're filing your taxes. This is something you need to get in a room by yourself, close the door, sit down, turn off your phone if you don't need it or unless you're using it for research. Look at this song, this particular song, which I'm going to explain right now. The song we're covering tonight for the Ghost Chorus is Machine Gun Kelly and Black Bear's My Ex's Best Friend. Really good song. It's on the charts right now. Big, big song. I'm going to let you hear the chorus in a minute, the original chorus, and then I'm going to show you, and then I wrote down their lyrics, and then I'll show you what I wrote for my lyrics, okay? But before we get into that, like I was saying, you got to tell a story. Like, in their words, they tell a story. Your words need to tell a story. They need to make sense and they need to rhyme. They need to be the same amount of syllables. When they start a word, you should start a word. When they end a word, you should end your words, and vice versa. It's you're following them to the letter, except you're writing your own words. Same melody, same everything, except your words. This is a tough exercise. This is not easy. If this was easy, everybody would do it, but it's not easy. So, and the other reason, you know, I always say to do this, it's really good for your brain. It's great for your imagination. It's great for your brain. You're taking a song that maybe you're very familiar with and you have to unthink it to write your own set of words. That's really hard to do. Like, imagine if you had to rewrite the national anthem. That is something so engrossed in our, just embedded in our heads, the way it goes. To write new words would take some serious thinking and then throwing the original away and only keeping the melody. And that's not easy to do. So these are tough. These are really, really tough things. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play you this chorus. I swear to God, I never fall in love. Then you showed up and I can't get enough of it. I swear to God, I never fall in love. I never fall in love, but I can't get enough of it. First off, I'm not sorry. I won't apologize to nobody. You play like I'm invisible. Girl, don't act like you ain't saw me. That's their chorus, okay? So what I did was I wrote down their words, okay? So here they are. He wrote, I swear to God, I never fall in love. Then you showed up and I can't get enough of it. I swear to God, I never fall in love. I never fall in love, but I can't get enough of it. So that's their words. Now, I'm going to show you my words, okay? So I wrote, you need to know, I really want to go. Can't take no more, just watch me walk right out the door. No compromise. I see it in your eyes. I see it in your eyes when we are both living a lie. So that's mine. So like I said, mine and theirs rhyme together perfectly. I'm going to say their first line and then my first line. I swear to God, that's theirs. Here's mine. You need to know. And then they say, I never fall in love. And I say, I really want to go. And then you showed up and I can't get enough of it. Then I wrote, just watch me walk right out of it. Yeah, can't take no more. That's right. I messed up. Sorry. Wait. Theirs is, I swear to God, I'll never fall in love. Then you showed up and I can't get enough of it. Then I wrote, you need to know, I really want to go. Can't take no more, just watch me walk right out the door. Then they go, I swear to God, I'll never fall in love. I'll never fall in love, but I can't get enough of it. Then I wrote, you know, no compromise. I see it in your eyes. I see it in your eyes when we are both living a lie. So that's mine. So if you look at mine and look at theirs, I start when they start, I stop when they stop. If they have one syllable words, I have one syllable words. Does my story make sense? My story makes sense. Does their story make sense? Of course, theirs makes sense. Okay, so I'm going to read mine like a poem. You need to know, I really want to go. Can't take no more, just watch me walk right out the door. No compromise. I see it in your eyes. I see it in your eyes when we are both living a lie. So those are my words. And now I'm going to run the whole thing. I found a karaoke version of this track, so I'm going to play that for you right now. So hold on. It's coming up. I really wanna go, can't take no more. that's the whole thing. All right, I hope you like that. I can't wait to see what you wrote for the ghost chorus to this song. All right, guys, that is all the time we have for tonight. This is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Seavey signing off. And I will see you guys tomorrow. So sleep well, and I love you. I miss you. Be safe, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.